Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome. Thank you so much for joining me today. If you are a returning subscriber, again, thank you so much for coming back and watching another video. Today we're going to be doing my paycheck number 3 breakdown for the month of July, and I'm also going to be doing my reconciliation for my second paycheck in July. So let's just go ahead and get started. If you like videos like this, consider subscribing and hit that like button. Today, you guys, I'm going to be opening up a new bubbly. Yes, I went to the store yesterday and I was looking for the pineapple. They did not have any pineapple. I didn't go to Target, so maybe that's why, but I did see another flavor that I've never tried, so I'm going to be opening that up now. All right, here it is. It's mango. Ooh wee, this is going to be interesting. I've never had mango sparkling water. I've had many sparkling waters, but I've never had mango, so let's just crack this open and see how it tastes. Wow, this is delicious. It tastes just like mango. It's amazing how these bubblies literally taste like what they are labeled. It is so refreshing. If you haven't tried mango, I suggest you guys try it. It is so good. Let me just adjust this camera so you can see my bubbly. And then here I have a tumbler that I bought from Brianna. I love it. I ordered 2 more, one for my nephew and then one for my sister. All right, so let's just get into reconciling my second paycheck in July. Okay, so I'm gonna enter my total income for this past pay period. I don't disclose my actual income, but I do disclose my total income, any rollover money, any replenishing, anything that came into my checking account as cash flow outside of my paycheck. So that amount for this past pay period was $2,292.37. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to add up my bills, add up my envelopes and my sinking funds, and then we're going to come back and subtract the total income. Okay, so now we're going to take this total, 229,237, and we're going to subtract 453,90. So that's 1838.47. I think that's in frame. Yeah, this is blocked. I can't see this section of the screen. Okay. So now we're going to subtract, we're going to add this amount up here, $1,838.47, and then we're going to subtract $386. That's $1,452.47. Then we're going to subtract $252. So that's $1,200.47. Okay, so now we're going to go to this section. And we're gonna add the amount up here. And then we're gonna add this up right here. That's $271.91, and then we're going to subtract that $1,200.47. So that's $928.56. Then we're going to subtract 80 from that. So that, you guys, is $848.56. Actually, that is in the wrong box. So this is going to be 80. And down here, I'm going to put $484.56. All right. So I'm going to show you how this balanced to the penny the day before I got paid. Okay. So you see here, the amount is $848.56. And that matches this amount here, $848.56. And I'm going to insert a screenshot of my checking account the day before I got paid. All right, you guys, so that is how I reconcile my paychecks. So I'm gonna go ahead and do my breakdown for paycheck number 3. So we're gonna be using the booklet for August. Even though my paycheck hit in July, I don't have any more bills in July. They're all paid, everything's done. So I'm gonna be using my last paycheck in July to pay my first 2 weeks of bills and expenses for August. So this is the August booklet from the Budget Mom. I love this. I love plants. These leaves are giving me life right now. I love the colors. It's so pretty. And then this is the back of it, the cheetah. And yeah, so let's just read the quote, because I always read the quote the first time I used a new booklet. The worst thing we can do is allow someone else's progress make us feel bad about our own. That is so true. I just recently made a comment to someone how sometimes, you know, it's, you know, we're imperfect. So we tend to compare ourselves or our channels maybe to someone else. But at the end of the day, don't allow that to hinder you. And if anything, motivate you to keep going. So yeah, that's my own little pep talk. So, all right, so let's just break down paycheck number 3 in July. I went ahead and filled out all of the categories because to save time on the video. Okay, I'm gonna zoom you in and I'm gonna take a little drink. Okay, so my rent is due actually tomorrow, so that's going to be $862.26. My rent also includes water, pest control, and garbage. So my car note came out when I got paid. So it's $145.41. JEA, which is my electric, is $71.17. That's pretty cool. And that's due on the 11th. And then my cell phone, I take out $20 each paycheck. All right, so let's go up here to my gas. So my gas is cashless, but I do budget $65. That stays in my checking account. Eating out is gonna get 50, spending 100. Compra is gonna get 140. Household is gonna get 5. Beauty through basically YouTube giveaway, they're all gonna get 5. Okay, the same thing for home decor, planner, and supplies. Support a friend is not getting any money. Gifts is getting 17. Car maintenance is getting 20. Medical 10. Emergency 40. Travel 15. Savings 30. Okay, so savings challenge this week is this paycheck is going to get $70 taken out. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and fill this part in, break down the denominations, then we're going to come back and total everything up. Okay, you guys, so what I did was, I don't want to keep using a second cash envelope breakdown for like another section, just because it's like a waste, because I'm not using the entire thing. So what I did was, I basically extended the bottom of this page, and because I don't use this section right here, money thoughts, and this section right here says priority goals. I don't use that section. So I went ahead and just created lines. That way I can keep everything on one sheet. All right, so now we're gonna enter my total count of all the bills in this section right here. Okay, so let's just add this up. So this is gonna be $12. 14 times 5 is 70. 9 times 10 is 90. 13 times 20. Hold on, let me just recount this. Oh, okay, so yeah, this is wrong. This is actually 12. Not 13. So 12 times 20 is 240. And then 3 times 50 is 150. Okay, so we're going to add this total. 150 plus 240 plus 90 plus 70 plus 12. So we are going to be cash stuffing $562, and that is correct. All right, you guys, so that is my paycheck number 3 breakdown for the month of July, basically paying my August bills. So this is the end of my video. I want to thank you guys so much for making it this far. Go ahead and click that subscribe button if you aren't already subscribed, and I greatly appreciate it. Don't forget to also leave a comment down below, and I hope everyone has an amazing rest of the day, morning, night, whenever you're watching this. And don't forget to always smile. Bye, guys.